While staying at the Jetavana Temple, the Buddha told a story from the past of how he acted for the good of his kinfolk. A long time ago, when Brahmadatta was reigning in Benares, the Bodhisattva was reborn as a dog due to his past karmic actions. He lived in a cemetery and was the leader of several hundred dogs. One day, after the king enjoyed a trip around the city on his chariot, it was left outside in the courtyard. That night, it rained and the chariot got wet. The smell of wet leather was too tempting for the palace dogs. They came down from their chambers to chew and gnaw the leatherwork and straps. The next day, the workers found the mangled chariot seats and told the king that city dogs came in through the sewers and chewed up his chariot's leather seats. The king was enraged. He ordered, "Kill all the city dogs! Kill all the dogs you see!" Thus began a large-scale slaughter of all the dogs in the city. Very few dogs were able to escape the widespread murder, and their corpses were dumped into a large pit outside the city. The few dogs were able to survive retreated to the cemetery. They went straight to the Bodhisattva. "Why have you all come here so frantically to the cemetery?" The dogs then told the Bodhisattva what had happened. The Bodhisattva calmed himself and applied his wisdom and discernment. He thought to himself, "No dogs from outside the palace are able to get into the palace. If dogs destroy the leather of a carriage inside the palace, it must have been done by the purebred dogs inside the palace. As such, the real culprits are safe inside the palace, while innocent dogs are being put to death. I must do something to save my kinfolk." The Bodhisattva reflected on his past paramitas and focused his mind on compassion. With his mind focused on compassion, he made his aspiration. "May no hand be lifted against me. May none throw stick or stone at me." He made his way alone through the city, unattended and unharmed. The Bodhisattva entered the Hall of Justice where the king was. At first, the guards were shocked that a dog was able to enter the palace, and they rushed to capture him. The Bodhisattva ran under the king's throne, and the king stopped them from capturing the brave dog. The Bodhisattva came out and bowed to the king. He then said, "Did you order that the dogs in the city are to be murdered?"
"Yes, it was my order."
"What is their offense?"
"They have gnawed on and destroyed the leather and straps of my royal carriage."
The Bodhisattva asked, "Do you know for certain which dogs did this?"
"No, I do not know for certain."
"If you do not know for certain, it is wrong for you to order to murder all dogs."
"But dogs are the ones that destroyed my carriage leather and straps."
"Then are you killing all dogs? Or are there some dogs which are spared?"
there are some dogs that are spared. My purebred dogs are spared from the kill order. My lord, you just said you ordered the widespread slaughter of all dogs, because dogs gnawed the leather of your carriage. Yet you now say that your palace dogs are exempt from your decree. That shows that you are following the four evil courses, making decisions based on partiality, dislike, ignorance, and fear is wrong and not proper for a king or one in power. Sire, what you are doing is not justice. Do you, in your wisdom, know who it actually was that gnawed the leather of my carriage? Yes, it was the dogs that live in your palace, and I can prove it to you with evidence. If you can prove it, then please do so. Have your soldiers gather a little buttermilk and kusa grass. Let this grass be mashed up into the buttermilk. Then, make the palace dogs drink it. The king did as the bodhisattva advised, and made the palace dogs drink the concoction. In turn, each of the several dogs that drank the concoction vomited. In their vomit, the bits of leather that they chewed was very clearly visible. The king was shocked and said,
"He spoke the truth. He was right. It was the palace dogs."
The king then paid homage to the bodhisattva by offering him the royal umbrella and a place of honor. The bodhisattva then told the king,
"Sire, a king ought to rule righteously, abiding in the three truths.
A king should put away all falsehood, anger, and scorn. He must not fall victim to passion and sin. He must be free from jealousy and a friend to all. He must be virtuous and zealous to do what is right. He must be earnest in doing good. No lazy king prospers. This is how a king should be. A king must not kill, not steal, not be adulterous, not use harmful speech, and must avoid intoxication. King, be steadfast and lead righteously." And with that, the bodhisattva returned the royal umbrella. At the end of the bodhisattva's words, the king ordered that all creatures should be safe from harm. He ordered that all dogs should have a constant supply of food. He followed the teachings of the bodhisattva and spent his life doing charity and good deeds. At the end of his life, he was reborn in the Deva heaven. And the Buddha concluded the Chathaka. The king of those days was none other than Ananda. The leader of the dogs was none other than I.
What did you learn from this story? Let us know in the comments. We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads. And consider making a donation to support our Buddhist animation project.